Each Taka of the cult of Kukulcan vows to tie his coat to that of Yutu, descendant of the Maya. Lacking any family of his own, each Taka will live with the parents of Yutu until such time that they have built their own home and hearth. Yutu vows to tie her coat to that of each Taka. She will bear him many children, which they will raise according to the traditions of both their peoples. We leave the city at first light, which is just as well, for a terrible disease has spread across it. Dead and dying line the paths and choke the streams. Many are saying it is punishment from the gods. Journal of Adelantado Perez. November 24th, 1603. I accompanied Andreas Lopez, a group of 12 soldiers and 2 molossers through the jungle. The directions the Jesuits provided to Trinity were excellent, so we discovered the hidden city with little difficulty. The natives of the city welcomed us warily, but we plied them with gifts, and they reluctantly allowed us to enter the city, unaware of our true intentions. Lopez has begun to search for the artifact while we distract the city's leaders. Thank you. That must be the temple I saw from the riverbanks. Hunbats and Hunchoen were twin brothers, older half-siblings of the more celebrated Maya hero twins. Jealous of their brothers, the monkey twins would always cheat during football matches and ruin them with their aggressive tactics. In retaliation, the hero twins lured them up a tree which never stopped growing, preventing Hunbats and Hunchoen from getting down. The hero twins convinced them that they could use their belts to climb down, but this turned out to be another trick, and the belts became tails, turning the elder twins into monkeys. Turn mirror 1 to the left. Follow the beam of light to mirror 2. Direct mirror 2 across the chamber diagonally. Return to mirror 1. These seem to be instructions of some kind, but I can't make out the rest. I must have arrived at the right time. It looks like the cultists were just here. Only the worthy may call upon K'nichihal. Use his light to chase the shadows from your hearts and the city itself. Amazing. This must be where they perform rituals honoring the sun. Four mirrors, each with a different marking. They're numbered. This is mirror 1. I'll need to go through the central pavilion to reach the altar. Thank you. I won't last long if I fall in the water. This is Mirror 2. Have to hit this crystal with a beam from Mirror 3. If I'm to get to Mirror 3, I'll have to turn Mirror 2. If I'm to get to Mirror 3, I'll have to turn Mirror 2. If I'm to get to Mirror 3, I'll have to turn Mirror 2. I think this is the way out. Can't make it across. I'll have to backtrack. If I'm to get to Mirror 3, I'll have to turn Mirror 2. Four mirrors, each with a different marking. They're numbered. I can get to Mirror 3 now. Mirror 3. I should direct Mirror 3's beam away from the pavilion. If I'm to get to Mirror 3, I'll have to turn Mirror 2. Yeah. The pillar between mirrors 1 and 2 can't make it across. I'll have to backtrack. Only one mirror left to move. Shark was a very important god to the Maya. He taught them farming secrets and oversaw growing and the harvest. Generally, he was associated with all forms of fertility. He was also in charge of wind, lightning, and rain, which was caused by his tears. He was in charge of preserving springs, wells, streams, cenotes, and other sources of water. Like the aspects over which he presided, he was considered benevolent and caring, but unpredictable. Physically, Shark was depicted as a reptile with hair tangled in unruly knots, and his colors were white, red, yellow, and black, representing north, east, south, and west. Now to find a way out of here.
Hmph.